Alright, this looks good.
Left in you. You're going to need it. Ready and stay sharp. This place is full of surprises.
This looks good.
Keep moving. There are more Daedra on the way. Let's keep moving.
Stop now. More guards are on the way.
Let's keep moving. Let's get out of here, my friend. The Prophet.
Greetings, Vesley. Like you, I am a prisoner in this place. You must rescue me, and I, in turn, must rescue you.
Hold a moment. Come here. We need to talk. The Prophet. He's a prisoner here, too. It was very dangerous for him to speak to you, even for a moment. You must think you can help me. Break him out, of course. Believe me, I can use all the help I can get. That blind old man is the only person alive who can help us get back home. Tamriel's a long way from here. These tunnels will eventually take us to the Towers of Eyes. That's where we'll find the Sentinels. Magical constructs created by Molag Vol to guide his vision in Cold Harbor. The Sentinels are connected. If we destroy one, the others will be blinded. With any luck, will buy us the time we need to free the Prophet. I've no idea. Brute force? We'll find a way. We have to. Be ready for anything. I doubt. I'm sure you do. And I'll answer. You're obviously not in Tamriel anymore. Think of the most miserable, depressing place you've ever been in your life. That's paradise compared to Cold Harbor. And to top it off, well, there's no easy way to say it. You're dead. I don't know. Once we rescue the Prophet, he can tell you about the gods and the ways of Oblivion. I don't understand any of it myself. A man named Menemarco. His worm cult is doing some kind of ritual back in Tamriel. They sacrificed you and everyone in this prison to the Daedric Prince Molag Vol. After you died, whatever was left showed up here. They call you the Soul Shriven. It means you're a slave and you'll spend the rest of eternity here in Cold Harbor, working under the lash of the Daedra. Unless, of course, you come. No, I wasn't sacrificed. The Prophet and I were brought here conventionally, if that makes any sense. But we're prisoners here. Same. It won't be easy. The place is watched by magical constructs called Sentinels. We won't stand a chance unless we can blind them. I'll tell you more when we get there. And we'll never get there if we don't get... We should keep moving.
Interesting.
Well played, friend. Mark his beard, you are good in a fight.
The god of brutality knows of your escape. Hurry.
The god of schemes can see every part of Cold Harbor. We need to distract him. What's your name again? Target practice? The sentinels are connected. If we destroy one, the others will also...
Oops. Take the weapons. Thank you.
some more, you skeeving hawkers.
Must level up like that automatically. It's cool.
God of self-punishment.
So they come back to life.
Been a fair fight, if there were three of you.
Yeah.
While he's blinded, we must get to the Prophet's cell.
What's that?
We'll never get in this way. Damn it. Destroying the Sentinel must have triggered these wards. We'll need to find another way in. Maybe Cadwell is the oldest of the Soul Shriven. After years of torment, Soul Shriven usually go insane and turn feral. But not Cadwell. He was already insane before he left Tamriel. Mad as a box of frogs, but completely harmless. Cadwell sees things as he wishes them to be. To him, Cold Harbor is a wondrous place. It's his home. And he knows it like the back of his hand. He's usually down by the river. Let's go find him.
Hey.
One fine day in the middle of the night, two dead kings got up to fight. Back to back, they faced each other, drew their bows, and stabbed themselves.
In there.
What's this? Out for a stroll then? Lovely day for it. Hello, what's this? Sir Cadwell, yes indeed, a pleasure. And fair Lyris, good to see you, my dear. How are you then? Oh dear, well that is inconvenient, isn't it? Tell you what, I happen to know another way in.
much more of a scenic route. Rather a fun little jaunt, actually, full of traps and corpses and nasty beasties filling up the bits in between. Rather cautiously, I expect. Watch your step, hold your nose, and do mind the traps. There'll like as not be a fair dose of running and skull bashing as well. Follow the river. You'll find the door to the Undercroft at the water's end. Once you're inside, stick to the light and you'll find a ladder that will take you right up to the Prophet straight away. Do give him my best. Best of luck. Do check in now and again, won't you? Well, there's not much to tell, is there? It's the same old pish-tosh, gallant knight, epic quests, rescued maidens. I came to this land when my head was quite unceremoniously separated from my body. Bad luck, that, but you make the best of things. Oh, quite a long time. In fact, I wouldn't be a bit surprised if I was the oldest of the Soul Shriven, of those who didn't go feral, that is. I know every tunnel and path, every nook and cranny. The others look up to me, I suppose. Ah, Lyris. Girl's as mad as Shirgoris jammies. Heart's in the right place, I suppose. Says she's got to rescue the Prophet to save us all from eternal torment. How an old blind man could do that is quite beyond me. An imperial gentleman. Apparently he was once a powerful mage, but the years haven't been kind. Lyris says he knows of a path back to Tamriel. I rather think that if one existed, I'd have found it by now. I hadn't actually given it much thought. Anything's possible, I suppose. Truth is, I've been here so long, this place feels like home. But a good uprising now and again is a pleasant diversion, so where's the harm, eh?
Seems to think this Undercroft is a delightful place. Probably means it's a death trap. Better be careful. The sooner you get that door open, the sooner we can get out of here. This is the part where you bleed to death.
Can't wait to get out of this place.
Did that hurt? It looked painful. Prophet's cage should be just ahead. Quickly now, we haven't much time. All right. The good news is we made it here in one piece, and the Prophet looks unharmed. Now the bad news. It's going to be up to you to keep him safe and get him back to Tamriel. I'm not going with you. There's a trick to opening the cell. The only way for a prisoner to leave is for another living soul to take their place. I need to swap places with the Prophet. Believe me, I wish there was, but I don't see anyone else here with a beating heart, do you? If Molag Bal isn't stopped, he'll destroy everyone and everything we've ever loved. Once it's done, get moving. The Prophet will know where to go, but he'll need your eyes and your protection.
kingdom! I remember this. Thank the divines you are safe. There is that at least. Dera sacrificed everything that we might go free. Her sacrifice must not be in vain. I wish that were possible, but I promise you, once we escape Cold Harbor, we will find a way to rescue her together, Vestige. That is the name I have given you. You are but a trace of your former self, a soulless one, an empty vessel that longs to be filled. It is, as the scrolls foretold, that is what I've come to be called. My true name is lost, even to me. Years of torment have taken their toll. Quickly now. The anchors are Daedric machines of the darkest magic. Their chains bind our world and pull it towards Cold Harbor. I can use one of these anchors to return us to Tamriel, but you must lead me to... Up the stairs, quickly! We must get to the anchor mooring! It is the dark anchor mooring.
A mortal thinks it can defy me. Futile. Soon your world will be in my chains.
Come, I will protect you. Anchor's portal is high above us. I will prepare a spell to lift us to it. But first, you must reattune yourself to Nern in order to regain your physical form. To do this, a shard of ethereal magicka that carries the essence of Nern. Some link them to Lorcan, the missing god of creation. If you collect and absorb its power, it should restore your corporeal form. I will summon one of these shards for you to absorb. Fall upon us now and anoint us with your blessing. There, quickly, collect the sky shard. Great Akatosh, dragon god of time, I require your strength. Let the way be opened. Let these wandering souls return home. Let the will of Molag Bal be denied. As I feared, we arrived in different locations. I am in a place with the smell of burning ash on a hot wind and the sounds of a distant battle. It matters not. You have awakened once again. Days, weeks, I cannot tell. The voids between worlds disrupted all sense of time and space. I know only that you were deposited into the sea and some charitable soul fished you out and brought you to... I'm afraid you will have to decide that for yourself. I must focus on searching for a way to repay Lyris's bold sacrifice. I cannot foresee that, not yet. But we will meet again. There is still much we need to accomplish. Be Be wary, Vestige. Our very plane of existence is in peril. The threat of Molag Bal looms across all Tamriel, and chaos spreads in its shadow. Danger roams the land. You must find your own path. But perhaps there is a reason for the place in which you find yourself. Explore. Search for a cause to lend your hand. Join with others. You might even seek out those who rescued you from the sea. The choice is yours. We do not face these troubled times alone. Many shall rise up to fight this tide of darkness. Wherever you go, you will encounter others who share your courage and valor. Help them if you can. Indeed, I sense that even now, there are good people near you who face grave danger. They need your assistance, should you be willing.
Just going to stand there.
Be wary, Vestige. You must find your own path.
You're the one Holsgar pulled out of the water. I'm glad you're up. I could use your help. A fisherman found you washed up on the beach. He brought you back to town. It's a miracle you survived. I'm short on good help, and I could use someone capable. Someone like you. You've seen combat, and I need all the help I can get today. Villagers are scattered across the island. We need to warn them. We sighted a ship offshore. I've sent my troops to investigate. If it's the vanguard of an invasion, well, we'll need to evacuate. You'll find the people of Bleak Rock all across the island. Darge, the hunter, went to Sky Shroud Barrow. Iman's out at Orky's Hollow with his sister, Rolanda. Sane, my sergeant, is out at Hosn's Folly. It's an old dragon shrine. It's a relic of the Dragon Wars. Some of the villagers, locals claim it's haunted. They dare each other to spend a night inside. It's an abandoned mine. A family came out from Stone Falls to work the place. Rumor has it, they're Daedra worshippers. Now some bandits are hunting through the place, and we need to know why. Locals claim it's haunted. They dare each other to spend a night inside. It's a silly custom, but a harmless one. It's an abandoned mine. A family came out. It's an old dragon shrine. It's a relic of the Dragon Wars. Some of the villagers claim they saw undead out there. I sent Darge out to get proof. Locals claim it's haunted. It's an old dragon shrine. Locals claim it's haunted. They dare each other to spend a night inside. It's a silly custom, but a harmless one. It's an abandoned mine. A family came out from Stone Falls to work the place. Rumor has it, they're Daedra worshippers. Now some... Thank you, friend. Once you've dealt with the bandits and sent Sane back here, I'll answer what I can. Captain Tilroni's got the villagers thinking I'm an...
Bleak Rock Isle.
Good to see you up and around. Figured you were crossing the bridge to Sovngarde for sure.
It's where I came from. I'm a ghost. Everything is like really large. Pretty.
This map block. Oh wow. This person tell me what that is. There's no one around.
Anna has no idea what she's
Hello.
Doing. Did I ever risk your lives like this?
Yes.
Why are they glowing?
I'm glad you're awake. When Horsguard brought you in, everyone thought for sure you'd die. Do I look like one? I'm glad you have to ask. I'm just Maisa's apprentice, so far, anyway. She's been teaching me for about a year now. Ah, yes. We start with a lump of metal and end up with something useful. Horseshoes and nails and swords and whatnot. I hear there are other kinds of crafters on the mainland, but I'd never be anything but a smith. Have you seen the size of Maisa's arms? Horsguard says she once punched out a mammoth. Smithing is a great way to let out frustration, especially after Otagar comes over. He's a fisherman. Fisher lad. He stops by every day to see me. He's always making dirty comments. Someday, my dad's going to hurt him.
Welcome to trouble. Our little Captain Rana doesn't know what she's doing. We spotted a ship offshore. I think it's the Daggerfall Covenant. They've claimed lands to the northwest across the High Rock and Hammerfell. It might be a scout, but I still think we're in for a fight. Hulsgar the Miller found you along the shore. He was certain you were going to die, but he dragged you back to town just the same. Bleak Rock Island. I was in command for years until Captain Rana took over. Now we sit on our hands while she dithers and frets. I repelled an Old Mary Dominion scouting party once, and we've had bandits and raiders aplenty. I handled every emergency, but Captain Rana won't listen to a word I say. Lighting the watchtower. When we spot a ship, we're supposed to send a signal. We spotted one, but Rana's delaying. She wants proof it's not a merchant, so she sent our only boat after the ship. It's loaded with the garrison's troops. Foolish girl. You did take a hit to the head. 10 years back, when the Akaviri invaded from across the Eastern Sea, the Nords, Dark Elves, and Argonians united to throw them back. Now, we're the Ebonheart Pact. Huh. Once we smashed those snakes, they didn't come back. Nowadays, we got other problems. The Daggerfall Covenant and the Aldmeri Dominion.
Hey, boo-hoo.
We have to evacuate. Rana has no idea what she's doing.
Cool.
It's an honor to serve the Ebonheart.
No fighting or spitting.
got it.
Anna has no idea what she's doing. Did I ever risk your lives like this?
Oh, there. Feeling better? What, this? It's good Skyrim weather. Not even... Aye, me and Tilrani. Built that house ourselves, board by board. When I got here, I never dreamed my commander would bed me. Even less that she'd like me enough to take Mara's vows.
Okay.